Hi guys, it's me, Leona, here to do a daily word with you guys. Today we're going to be talking about what's so good about Good Friday. Okay, but let's pray. Heavenly Father, I just thank you so much for this beautiful day that you've given to us. And I thank you for sending your son, Jesus, to die for our sins so that we could have eternal life. Father, I pray that our ears would be open and our hearts would be open to what you have to teach us today, Father. Bless my brothers and sisters, Lord, all that are here, all that are listening, Lord, and just hear their cries, Father God, and may your will be done in all of our lives, Father. Speak to our hearts now, God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hey, guys, I hope everybody's doing good. Anyway, well, let's get into God's Word and let's find out about what's so good about Good Friday. Why do we call Good Friday good when it's such a dark and bleak event? Commemorating a day of suffering and the death of Jesus. For Christians, Good Friday is a crucial day of the year because it celebrates what we believe to be the most momentous weekend in the history of the world. Ever since Jesus died and was raised, Christians have proclaimed the cross and the resurrection of Jesus to be the decisive turning point of all creation. Paul considered to be of first most importance that Jesus died for our sins and was buried and was raised to life on the third day in accordance with what God had promised all long ago in the scriptures. In Corinthians 15:3, in God's word, it says, "For what I received, I passed on to you as the first importance that Christ died according to the scriptures." So it's followed by Easter, the glorious celebration of the day Jesus was raised from the dead, heralding his victory over sin and death and pointing ahead to the future resurrection for all who are united to him by faith. And in Romans 6:5, in God's word, it says, "Since we have been united with him in his death, we also will be raised as he was. Our old sinful selves were crucified with Christ so that sin might lose its power over our lives. We are no longer slaves to sin, for when we died with Christ, we were set free from the power of sin. And since we died with Christ, we know we will also share in this new life. We are sure of this because Christ rose from the dead. And he will never die again. No longer has death have power over him. He died once to defeat sin, and now he lives for the glory of God. So you should consider yourselves dead to sin and able to live for the glory of God through Christ Jesus. Do not let sin control the way you live. Do not give in to its lustful desires. Do not let any part of your body become a tool of wickedness to be used for sinning. Instead, give yourselves completely to God. Still, why call the day of Jesus' death Good Friday instead of Bad Friday or something similar? Some Christians' traditions do take this approach. Like in German, for example, the day is called Karfreitag, a sorrowful day, a sorrowful Friday in English, in fact. So, some believe this will develop from an older name, God's Friday. Regardless of the origin, the name Good Friday is entirely appropriate because the suffering of the death of Jesus, as terrible as it was, marked the dramatic culmination of God's plan to save his people from their sins. So, in order for the good news of the gospel to have meaning for us, we must have to understand the bad news of our condition as sinful people under condemnation. The good news of deliverance only makes sense once we see how we are enslaved. Another way of saying this is that it's important to understand and distinguish between law and gospel and scripture. We need the law first to show us how hopeless our condition is. The gospel of Jesus' grace comes and brings us relief and salvation. The law, the Ten Commandments, have no other gods before you. Do not use the Lord God's name in vain. You know, you got to go look up the Ten Commandments and you'll find out. We've done those before, so, and I know, but right now I want to finish my Bible study, okay? So in the same way, Good Friday is good because as terrible as that day was, it had to happen for us to receive the joy of Easter. The wrath of God against sin had to be poured out on Jesus, the perfect sacrificial substitute, in order for forgiveness and salvation to be poured out onto the nations. Without that awful day of suffering, sorrow, and shed blood at the cross, God could not be both just and justifier of those who trust in Jesus. So let's go to Romans 3:26. And Romans 3:26, in God's word, it says, I got to turn one more page. Sorry about that, guys. And he is entirely fair and just in this present time when he declares sinners to be right in his sight because they believe in Jesus. So in the same way, Good Friday is good because as terrible as that day was, it just had to happen. Had to happen for us to receive the joy of Easter, like I said. So, the cross is where we see the great suffering of God's forgiveness. In Psalms 85:10, it sings of a day when the righteousness and peace will kiss each other. The cross of Jesus is where that occurred, where God demands his righteousness, coincided with his mercy. We receive divine forgiveness, mercy, peace, because Jesus willingly took our divine punishment, the result of God's righteousness against sin, for the joy set before him. Jesus endured the cross on Good Friday, knowing it led to his resurrection and our salvation, and the beginning of God's reign of righteousness and peace. Good Friday marks a day when wrath and mercy met at the cross. That's why Good Friday is so dark and so good. Because Jesus died for us so that we could all be forgiven. We could all have eternal life. It says in God's word, no one is good, not even one. No one has real understanding. All have turned away from God. All have gone wrong. No one does good, not even one. Their talk is foul like the stench from an open grave. Their speech is filled with lies. The poison of deadly snake drips from their lips. Their mouths are full of cursing and bitterness. They're quick to commit murder. Wherever they go, destruction and misery follow them. They do not know what true peace is. They have no fear of God to restrain them. Obviously, the law applies to those to whom it is given, for its purpose is to keep people from having excuses and to bring the entire world into judgment before God. For no one can ever be made right in God's sight by doing what his law commands. For the more we know God's law, the clearer it becomes that we aren't obeying it. Christ took the punishment for us. But now God has shown us a different way of being right in his sight. Not by obeying the law, but by the way promised in the scriptures long ago. We are made right in God's sight when we trust in Jesus Christ to take away our sins. And in 3 days, he rose again in fulfillment with the scriptures. So we have hope of eternal life, guys. All we have to do is believe in Jesus and do the best we can to follow him. In his word, you can find out everything about him. I've told you this a million times, guys. You can learn about Jesus. You can learn about his life, what he went through for us. And maybe we could just give in a little bit and start and try to do the right thing. You know, start today, guys. Start today by maybe forgiving someone that you have forgiven. Maybe by loving people, not for what they do for you, but just for who they are. They're a child of God. All right, guys. Well, love you guys. Jesus loves you guys too. And remember, keep up the faith. And I'll talk to you guys soon. God bless you all. Thank you.